This week's Word of the Week comes from Pastor James Bolton, pastor of Tree of Life Ministries, Hattiesburg, Mississippi.
Come on, clap your hand and give God some praise. Ladies and gentlemen, stand on your feet to receive my brother, Pastor James Hollis Bolton, Tree of Life, Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Come on, give him one more praise tonight. Come on, bless him like you're excited. Come on, touch that neighbor. Your neighbor, tell it's not as bad as it seems. Tell him again, tell him it's not as bad as it seems. Tell him everything will be all right. Tell him. Come on, give God a praise one more time. Let everything that has what?
Breath.
Do what?
Praise the Lord.
All right, let's do it again. Let's do it again. Let what?
Everything.
That has what?
Breath.
Do what?
Praise the Lord.
Let's try it one more time. Let?
Everything.
That has what?
Breath.
Do what?
Praise the Lord.
Now touch your neighbor. Say, neighbor, if you're breathing tonight, you owe God a praise. So come on, let's praise him. Come on, praise him like you're excited. Praise him like he's on the Lord is your strength. Come on, praise him. Praise him like this may be your last time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, man. Bless him. Lift your hand in the presence of the Lord. Just tell him thank you. Come on, tell him thank you one more time. How many are grateful tonight? I said, how many are excited tonight about what God is doing in your life tonight? Hallelujah. Stay on your feet and just join and help us sing with the rest of the song. Hallelujah. Thank you. You are. Oh, everybody. You, Lord, oh, I want. God bless you. Hallelujah. Not going to be long, just a few minutes. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord for this soul-saving revival. My God, my God. Yeah. Bless you to the set bishop of this house. Little pastor, my big brother, we bless God for him tonight. As we said on Monday night, amen, hold your music. We thank God for the bulldozer that made the way easy for us on Monday night. And he came again on last night. Ms. Doris said made it easy for us tonight. Amen. So we want you to just believe God. How many need a miracle from God?
Yes, sir.
Real quick.
Yes, sir.
Amen. How many really need God to move for you right now? I wish I had about three people that hold your music. I wish I had about three people that don't have to wait till the battle is over. I wish I had some shouters right now. Matter of fact, ask your neighbor questions. Say, neighbor, if God right now. Tell me, say, neighbor,
if God
right now, on this Wednesday night, will do everything you asked him to do this year. If he will do everything you've asked him to do this year, if he will do it for you right now, say, show me how you will react right now if he did. Say, show me. John chapter 5. Lord, if you don't help me, I can't stand the storm. Lord, if you don't help me, yeah, I can't stand. Catch your fire. You have to have a certain position to feel the Holy Ghost. Somehow, something said, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall. Hallelujah. want to know you're saved tonight. John chapter 5, real quick. Not going to be long. Hallelujah. Amen. All right. Let me turn around. Can you see over there? Let me turn that thing around. John 5, let's share verse number 2 first. If you have it, say amen. Verse number 2, let's read together and read loud. You may read now. A pool. But there's a heaven high porch. Verse number 3, everybody. Folks. Waiting for the moving of the water. Verse number 4. Watch verse number 4. Read loud, everybody. And trouble the water. Read on. Watch this now. Then, after the trouble of the water, from whatsoever disease. Now, it says for Teresa, an angel. What? But come down, went down and troubled the water. Now let's move at verse number 6. Read. When Jesus lied, in that cave, watch this. He said unto him, what? Now I'll say that part again. He said, what? Will thou be made whole? Now at this point, Jesus proposed a question. Now watch now. At verse 6, he said, will thou be made whole? Now let's look at verse number 8. Read. Alright, now watch what happened. This way. In verse 6, Jesus proposed a question. But in 8, he gives a command. So, Caleb, something had to happen between 6 and 8. Somebody gonna help me teach. Why he asked a question in 6 and gives a command in 8. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, I wanna know what happened. Something had to happen. Well, let's go back one more time, because I'm about done. When we get through reading, I'm going to be about done. Let's go back to verse number 2 again. Let's read it. Everybody again. There's a God bless you. May have you see. I want to just share this thought about there was trouble on the porch. That's real something. Amen.
Trouble.
There was trouble on the porch. Touch yourself. Say, self, get off the porch. Come into the house. John helps us to understand tonight that Jesus was more than just a natural man. Help somebody. But Jesus was the Savior. Come on, somebody. He is the Savior. So in John writing, he was kind of more like an eyewitness. Come on, somebody. He was right there on the scene. Come on, touch it and say, neighbor. It makes a difference sometimes when you see it for your own self. And so now, Jesse, watch here. We're not going to be long. I'm looking at the clock. It's 10 minutes to 9. Touch your neighbor. Say, he need 21 minutes. Say it loud. He need 21 minutes. All right. Pick up at verse number 2 again. Watch what happened here. Read.
Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the
Bruton, having what?
Having five porches.
Having five porches. Read on.
In these lay a great multitude of impotent people.
Uh-huh.
Of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the movement of the water.
One more. Read one more.
For an angel.
For an angel. Stop right there. Now watch this, y'all. Now at this time, that's what the scripture said, Bishop.
Yeah, yeah.
For an angel will come down at a certain season into the pool and what? Trouble the water. But now watch this here. Now it says here that these folks, these sick folk were on this porch sitting around the pool. Help me somebody. You know, just can imagine a whole lot of church folks. Of folks in general that want America. You know it had to be some disturbance going on that porch. Oh, help me. First of all, what is a porch? A porch is an outside entrance. Come on, somebody. Back yesterday, you know, we had what we call a front porch. And when the conversation would get too hot for us, I could hear most of y'all children go around to the back porch. Come on, somebody. That means that you're at the house, but you're not in the house. Oh, come on, somebody. A lot of folks is at the church, but they're not what? I'm about done. I'm just about there. Touch it as an neighbor. Get off the porch and come on in the house. Cause you know, on the porch, there's a whole lot of stuff going on. You got a whole lot of gossip in church, folks. Y'all not gonna help me teach tonight. That's why your name's your neighbor. I hope you're not on the porch tonight. So now, it said these impotent folks sit around the pool. Oh, help me somebody. You know, back yesterday, when you got baptized in the creek, come on somebody, you have to get in the water to get wet. You can't prove you can swim while you're on the bank. You can talk about how you can die. Come on, somebody. But until you get in the water.
You preaching right.
So, watch this.
Yes, sir.
It says here now, the healing, Miss Teresa, at this time, was in the pool. Alright, don't take my word. Read verse number 4. Watch it out. Here you go. Say what?
For an angel.
For an angel.
At a certain season.
At a certain season.
Into the pool.
Into the pool.
And trouble the water.
And trouble the water. Touch it in his name. I need my water trouble tonight. I feel my head, y'all. Watch this here. I'm about done. What's this now? But then, what is this in this cup? That's what makes sugar. Sure, folks think you're some kind of trick. Sugar. Pour sugar in the water. The sugar is in the water.
Yeah. It's in the water.
Is it? Y'all not going to help me teach. It's in the water. But it done floated to the bottom. Oh, help me somebody. I need your little sister right here for a minute. A lot of folks at the church, you got your job in you, but it done floated to the bottom, and your job in you. Stop!
Jesus.
Saw him.
Saw him. Saw him.
Knew that he had been now a long time.
Jesus knew
in that
how long
case.
He'd been there.
Jesus knew the problem.
He knew how long he'd been in
this.
Well,
who knew?
No. He knew. He knew how. Check it out. Now, this in verse 6. He said, do you want what I have for you?
All right. Yes.
You don't need to tell me how long I've been here.
Yeah.
I don't need to know how long you've been here. I already know.
Yeah.
I've checked out you.
Yeah.
My angel be here.
Yeah.
They trouble the water.
Yeah.
But somebody beat you in. So I come that you may have life.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, that's a mistake. I come that you may be healed. Now, do you want to come off the ball?
Yeah.
But watch how he responds.
Watch it, watch it.
Watch what happened. Read. Verse 7, watch what happened.
The impotent man answered him, sir.
Sir.
I have no man.
Stop. First of all, he didn't talk to Jesus.
Look out,
Jen.
Look out.
Yeah.
Has somebody?
Yes, sir.
He looked at the Savior.
Yeah.
And talked about, I have no man.
Look out.
Jesus trying to tell him that I am the man.
Yeah.
Some of y'all missed that.
Yeah.
I am the rock.
Yeah.
I wish I had a pep. I am the Savior.
Yeah.
And whatever you need,
whatever.
Yeah. See, we're going to get what that happened. We're going to chat, but we're looking for the wrong stuff.
Preach, man. Preach.
So, Jesus said, I'm here. I came to rescue you.
Came to rescue you.
You don't even know who I am. You looking at me talking about, you have no man. Don't you know that I am that I am? Don't you know that I am the King of Kings? I am the Lord of Lords. I am your healer. But watch what happened. Watch what happened. Then he said, I have. No man, here go. When what?
When the one
feels
trouble
to put me to the pool.
Yeah.
I looked at that thing.
Look at it.
Come
here.
Come on. He said, I have no man.
No man.
Yeah.
First of all, he insulted. When the water. Then he brings up something. He brings up something to Jesus that he gave order for the angel. Somebody missed it. When Jesus shows up, he don't need water. I wish I had somebody. Touch your neighbor, say neighbor. When the Holy Ghost shows up. Because water will not save you. Water will not heal you. Somebody said, what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the water.
The blood.
Nothing but the water.
The blood of Jesus.
Nothing but the water.
The blood of Jesus.
Get on your feet and give God a praise up in hell. Up in hell. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Y'all sit down, you make me nervous. Watch this. And I'm done. I got 4 minutes left. Now,
preach.
Watch what happened. He says, I have no man.
Yeah.
When the water is trouble.
It's trouble.
Come on.
To put me into the pool.
Yes, sir.
But Jesus. He never asked him.
That's all right.
You're an architect.
He never asked him to get in the pool. He just said, will thou be made whole? Touch your name's neighbor. God don't want to hear your excuses. You don't like me, that's your problem. I wish I had a baby though. You don't feel no anointing, that's your problem. I wish I had about 13 people that believe God for a miracle right now. The trouble will be to turn around one time and shout, it's my miracle time right now. So, now we're close.
Amen.
Watch what happened. He said, read on. He said,
I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming.
But while I am coming.
All right, make it plain now.
Another
step
down
before me. So if you look at it, it would have been Jesus in a reason to come. Because the man comes back.
That's right.
Because when the angel come down, somebody stepped in before him.
Yeah.
So Jesus shows up and said, will thou be made whole? And he tells Jesus, I have no man. He's still talking about the pool, but Jesus never mentioned the pool at this time. You still hung up your greater faith about what happened yesterday. You don't like folk for what happened before. Y'all help me, somebody. Touch your neighbor's neighbor. Let it go. I'm proud of your neighbor's neighbor. Let it go. Forget about who don't like you. And let God give you your deliverance. Here go. He said, but, wow. Ain't gonna hurt you. I used to haul paper wood too. Stay right there. Let's get the text. He said, but while I'm coming. See, now you want to know, just hold on. Stay with me. Hold on. I'm going to show you.
Do it, man.
I'm going to show you what made Jesus move. Oh, come on, somebody. Even though the man said, but while I'm coming, everybody still coming. Step. That's an action verb. Somebody missed that revelation. He said, evidently, the man was not as handicapped as they pretend he was. Because he said, wow, I'm what? Somebody going to help me too. Touch your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I may be crippled, but I'm on my way. I may be sick, but I'm on my way. I may have some pain, but I'm on my way. Touch your neighbor. Say, neighbor, to get my healing, I'm on my way to get my deliverance, I'm on my way to get what God has for me. Everybody stand on your feet and give God praise. I'm done. Praise God with me. But if you're not on your way, we'll help you get on your way. I'm going to tell you what, people tonight. That mount you on your way. Get out of your seat. Get down to this altar. And begin to praise God. Come on, tell us about all of us. Come on, be down over there.
Somebody get happy for him. Somebody get happy for him. Somebody get happy with him. Come on, somebody. Somebody needs to deliver from drugs. Somebody still smoking pot in that woman. You need to deliver us tonight.
Yeah.
Somebody said, live about this. The Bible says to the robber, and as they went, and as they went, they were healed. When he made it to the priest, the priest declared, y'all ain't saying nothing, that they were truly delivered from leprosy. But only one came back and said, thank you. And I wonder how many of you had a miracle work in your life that you don't want to experience. Open your mouth right now and lose your mind. Tell God, thank you. What you know about Jesus? He's all right. What you know about Jesus? He's all right. What you know about Jesus? He's all right. What you know about Jesus? Take on my team.
Ghost.